everyone, welcome to Amarjyoti's Crochet World. Today I am here with my new tutorial, and today I am going to make something helpful for beginners. Today I will be making one circular ball which can be used for amigurumi purposes, and this is the basic circle or the basic ball or the basic amigurumi portion that we are going to make for the head or for the kind of amigurumi purpose. So let's begin making this. And one thing I'll show you, I will be making this without using any stitch marker. As usually I used to take the stitch marker, but sometimes we feel that there is no stitch marker. Not all of you have stitch markers, so I'll give you the substitute for using this stitch marker. So the yarn that I am using is acrylic yarn. I'm taking this yarn for making our amigurumi ball, and a tapestry needle to sew the ends, a pair of scissors to cut the ends, and we need fiber filling to fill in the ball, and the crochet hook that I am going to use is 3mm crochet hook. And the substitute for this stitch marker, I'm taking a piece of yarn, any color alternative to this color which can be visible over this. So if you are working with any dark color, then the light color yarn piece, a very small piece, this much is quite larger, but you can take a small piece also at this much, 3 to 4 inches. So you can take the alternate color of yarn which can be used as the stitch marker. So let's begin making this amigurumi ball. So first of all, make a magic ring. How I am going to make a magic ring is holding the end on two fingers of my hand and with the thumb, and then wrapping it around my fingers. Now you'll find an X over my hand. So this one, the first yarn, I am going to go through below this yarn and pulling the upper yarn. This is the upper yarn and this is the base yarn. So base yarn will be below and upper yarn is over that. So going through the base yarn and pulling the upper yarn like this. How I did, once again I'll show you. This is the basic beginner friendly tutorial, so I am going to show it once again. So wrapping the yarn over my fingers like this, making an X over my fingers, going through the base yarn, below the base yarn, and pulling the upper yarn through it like this. And now I will hold it like this. Oops, like this. This is your ring. Make a single crochet. So this is your first stitch in the through the ring. This will hold your ring. So we will be working in this ring. This is a magic circle. So we will be working in this magic circle. So as I told you, we are going to make a ball, amigurumi ball. So we are working in single crochet. Therefore, amigurumi purposes, single crochet is the best stitch because it doesn't leave any hole or any gap between the stitches. So we are going to make single crochet in the magic circle. How I am going to make the single crochet? Going inside the magic circle and pulling the yarn like this, and wrapping over the yarn over the hook, and then pull through all the two loops. This is one single crochet. Once again, going inside the magic loop or magic circle, pulling the yarn. Now two loops you have on the hook. Now yarn over your hook and then pull through all the two loops. This is your single crochet. So like this, two single crochet I have made. I am going to make six single crochet in total. Two I have done. Now third, like this. Fourth, fifth, and sixth. total 6 single crochet I have made in the magic circle. Now this loose end I am going to pull it and close the loop. So your circle is closed. Now this was your first round. At this point of time, as we used to mark our first stitch, now we are going to mark the end of our round. So I am taking this piece of yarn and bringing it here in between the last stitch and the first stitch of next round. So I am holding this like this. Now you will find the first stitch, insert the hook in this first stitch, pull the yarn two loops and pull yarn over and pull through all the two loops. This is your first stitch in the second row. Now you have marked with the stitch marker, that is your own yarn stitch marker. So for second round we are going to make 2 single crochet in each stitch. In the same single crochet I am going to make one more single crochet. For making a circle, the basic thing is, in the whatever stitches you are taking in the first round, in the second round there will be double, in the third round there will be one single crochet or one double crochet, whatever stitch you are using, and there will be increase or 2 stitches in next stitch. So like this, I'll show you. Now second round, here's the second single crochet. Make one single crochet in this and another single crochet in this. One single crochet in this and second single crochet in the same. Next stitch, one single crochet in this next stitch and the other second single crochet in the same stitch. One single crochet in this next stitch, another in the same. So 2 single crochet in the same stitch we are going to make. So total stitch count after round number 2 will be 12. In the last round it was 6 and we have made 2 single crochet in each stitch. So total stitch count after round number 2 is 12. Now how I am going to start the round number 3. Now you have this yarn. Now bring it forward like this. Now you have marked this row. Or the other thing is, if you are taking a small yarn, you can remove it from here. Just remove it from here and then reattach it over here like this. Now round number 3, one single crochet in the first stitch and in the next stitch I am going to make 2 single crochet. Now again one single crochet in the first stitch, 2 single crochet in the next. One single crochet in the first stitch and 2 single crochet in the next stitch like this. One in the next and 2 in the next. So the sequence is one single crochet in the first stitch and 2 single crochet in the next stitch. So the last stitch I am having now, making 2 single crochet in the last stitch. So total stitch count after round number 3 is 18. In the last round we have, in the first round we had 6 stitches, second round we had 12 stitches and in the third round we have 18 stitches. Now starting the fourth row, I am taking this yarn and bringing it back. Now we are going to work in the first stitch, make one single crochet in the first, one in the second and in the third make 2 single crochet. Now the sequence will be one in the first, one in the second and 2 single crochet in the third stitch. One, one and 2. One, one, 2. One, one, 2. One, one, 2. So total stitch count after round number 4 will be 24. So we are going to take this 24 as our last round. Otherwise you can increase it if you want to increase, like we had one single crochet in first, one in second and two in third. Now in round number 5 we will be having one in first, one in second, one in third and two in fourth. So this way we will be increasing our circle, but I am leaving it like this. And now I am going to make one single crochet in each of the stitches to make it a round ball. Now one in each of the stitches, one single crochet in each of the stitches. Now I am not going to make an increase, I am just making one single crochet in each of the stitches. Total stitch count will remain 24. Like this. So one round with one single crochet in each stitch. Like this I'll complete total four rounds. Like fifth round with one single crochet, sixth round with one single crochet, seventh round with one single crochet and eighth round with one single crochet. By taking this yarn again back and forth to mark the next row. So like this I'll complete 8 rows and I'll meet you at the end of 8th row. Now I have finished 8th round. Now your ball has taken this shape of a bowl. Now we will be decreasing it to make a circular ball. So 9th round we are going to start, and bringing my yarn forward to mark the next row. So this time I'm going to let me tell you the technique. Last round of increasing was one single crochet in two stitches, and in the third stitch we had two stitches, like 1 1 2. The last round of increase was like this: one single crochet in first stitch, one single crochet in second and two in the third. Like this when we will be decreasing, we will reverse the order of increasing. So this way we will be working one single crochet in first, one in second and a decrease in the third stitch. So how we are going to decrease it, I will show you. This is the first single crochet, round number 9 I am going to start. One single crochet in first stitch, one single crochet in the second stitch. Now you have 3 and 4 stitches. So take the, you will see a V of third stitch. So the first loop or the first yarn, take that and again take the first loop of fourth stitch and wrap the yarn and pull through these two loops, and wrap the yarn and pull through all the two loops. So this way we have decreased two stitches I have stitched together. So this is the technique of using the front loops, the first loops, for making two stitches. One is called invisible decrease. So in amigurumi this decrease is very much important. So we are going to make an invisible decrease. So what I am going to do in the 9th round is one single crochet in the first stitch, one in the second stitch, and taking the front loops of third stitch and fourth stitch together and yarn over and pull through the loop. Now you have two loops in the hook, and yarn over and pull through all the two loops. So two stitches are made, one stitch. So this way this is a decrease, and this decrease is called as invisible decrease. So this way I am going to work for the whole round, one single crochet in first, one single crochet in second and an invisible decrease in the third and fourth. One in the first, one in the second, and invisible decrease in the third and fourth. One in the first, one in the second, invisible decrease in the third and fourth. One in the first, one in the second, and the last two stitches you have left, take the front loop of both the stitches and make a single crochet through it. So total stitch count after row number 9 is 18. Like we had, after increasing we had 24 stitches, before 24 we had 18 stitches, before 18 we had 12 stitches, and before 12 we started with 6 stitches. The reverse order will be to make it a ball. So now round number 10, I am going to start marking with the yarn. Now in this round number 10, our sequence will be one single crochet in the first stitch and an invisible decrease in the next stitch. So this way, this is the reverse of this round. So one single crochet in the first and taking the front loops together and yarn over and pull through the loop and yarn over and pull through all the two loops. So this way, one single crochet I have done. Now one single crochet in the first and an invisible decrease in the next. One single crochet in the first and invisible decrease in the next. One in the first, invisible decrease in the next. One single crochet in the first and two stitches, last two stitches are left. So take the front loop of both the stitches, yarn over, pull through the loop, yarn over and pull through the two loops. So total stitch count after round number 10 will be 12. So at this point of time, pull the stitch so that it will not get closed and take out the marker yarn. I'm just pulling it out like this. In this way, it is neat and clean. You will not find anything. You don't know where it was attached. And now when you have 12 stitches in total remaining at the end, this point of time we are going to fill the circle with our fiber fill. You may be knowing, one more technique I'll tell you. You may be knowing that this much fiber filling will be in the, will be filled in the circle, but don't try to put it this much at once. Just take small quantities of fiber filling and then open the mouth with the help of your finger or a stick or the back side of your crochet hook. Just start filling it and fill it in such way that it is spreaded properly, evenly to all the sides. Take small quantities of filling, start inserting evenly to all the sides so that its round shape is maintained. Don't try to put large quantities of filling in the amigurumi, any kind of amigurumi, because if you insert large stuffing at once, this will distort the shape of your amigurumi. Whatever circle, whatever cone, whatever cylindrical shape you are making, you have to insert small quantities of stuffing at one time. Like this. You can take any stick also, but I used to do with the back of my crochet hook or with my fingers. So it is stuffed like this, not very hard, not very soft, so it's sufficient. Now next round we have 12 stitches in total at the end. Now I am going to decrease it to 6. So I am going to take 2 stitches together every time. So taking 2 stitches together 6 times, so making, bringing it to 6, taking the front loop of first stitch, second stitch, and making it one stitch. This is second time I have decreased. Now again a decrease for the third time, again a decrease for the fourth time, decrease for the fifth time, and a decrease for the sixth time. So this is your six stitches in total. Now at this point of time, in the next stitch, make a slip stitch. How I am going to make a slip stitch is inserting my hook through the next stitch, yarn over, and pulling the stitch, pulling the yarn, and then that yarn is pulled through the stitch. So this is your slip stitch, and this is your chain one, and cut a long tail so that your its mouth is closed. Now pull the yarn and then make it tight. Take the tapestry needle and now I'm going to close the this little opening. Take the front loop of first stitch like this and front loop of next stitch from backward like this, next stitch from forward like this, and front loop from backward like this, six times, and this the last stitch, and pull the yarn. This will close the mouth of the center. Tie a knot and hide the yarn inside your amigurumi and cut the extra tail. This way your perfect circle is done. You can make it as a head of any amigurumi doll or any project of making a circular amigurumi. You can make it as the base. This is the basic thing to make it a make a circle and converting it into a circular ball. So hope you like my video on making this beautiful basic thing for beginners, because sometimes we don't know the basic things, so how to make a circular ball. So hope you like my video on making this beautiful ball. Please give it a thumbs up and for getting the notification each and every time I upload a new video on my channel. And thank you for watching my videos. Thank you once again.